standing up, sometimes raising our hands. But one of the things we've forgotten to do as a church, perhaps, is fall down on our knees. The place of humility before God. Let's come to Him this morning in worship. We come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Faithful One, whose word is life, come with saving power to free our praise, inspire our prayer, and shape our lives for the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Do please sit down. In this church, we celebrate birthdays because people's families are all over the world. And we were going to celebrate Michael's birthday this morning, but he, as I mentioned earlier, was COVID, and it's not here. And he was looking forward. He had signed himself up to do the prayers for that. And then yesterday he was supposed to be on the Witty Walk and wasn't able to be on that either. So they made a cake for him. And this is it. Thank you, Justin. So it says, there's a Michael, happy birthday. It's got a backpack. It has walking shoes. And this was all prepared for him. But he wasn't there, and he is not here. And well, there it is. And Josephine and Graham are going to be taking the top of that cake to Michael.
The Willy Walkers.
This is show and tell time, it looks like. but most of the cake is going to be available to you this morning after the service. Along with two of our Indian friends at the back, I've got some Indian sweets, so we're going to have a mixture of food available with tea and coffee after the service. So thank you very much, Josephine, for doing that. Anyone, another person whose birthday is, who was supposed to be here this weekend, many of you remember Elena, who was a member of this church. It was her birthday too, the same day, but Elena wasn't able to come for various reasons. And instead, what she was going to do tonight was go to a classical concert in Palau Música. So she sent me the ticket yesterday and said, John, if you know anyone who wouldn't mind going by themselves. And I thought, Jenny, our youth worker, would probably enjoy that. And so Jenny is going tonight to Elena's place to allow to this musical concert. And it's Elena's birthday as well. So anyone else's birthday in the week who's passed or in the week to come? Your daughter's birthday today, and Cassie's birthday was on Tuesday. Friday wasn't. Yeah, Friday, that's right. No, yes, because Tuesday was my daughter's birthday, and I got the day wrong. It was actually Thursday. So she said, thank you very much, Dad. It was, as many of you know, I was on a retreat last week, and I lost all sense of time. I thought the fifth was the seventh. So my wife said, you must have been enjoying the retreat, John, because you were living in a completely different world. Completely different time gone. My daughter said, thank you very much, Dad, for your loving message. I expect another one on Thursday. So there we are. Anyone else birthday? Let's sing happy birthday. Sherry, would you like to come on up, please? And so for the foreseeable future, Sherry is going to be coordinating the work of music in this church. I would just like to say thank you very much. It was unanimous, as you know, from the council. And we'd like to pray for her and commission her. And it's a very ancient tradition. You see it in the New Testament, of people laying hands on it. And you can even see it in the Old Testament, as they lay hands on those who are being set apart for the community. So if I may, I'm going to lay my hand on you. And all of you who wish, please put your hands out, and we're going to commission and bless her again. Sherry, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and look kindly upon you and be gracious to you. And as you take up new, this new responsibility, on top of everything else, you do to serve this church with such a willing heart. May God bless you. May the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit be upon you. And may you know his love and enabling. And may we be blessed for you. In Jesus' name.
I would like to put the John in the Thank you.
I just guarantee you think to say that you will all be happy is an impossible phrase. It's one of these things when ministers get together, the stories of music and how you cannot make everyone happy with music are told by ministers. But I think the willingness and the readiness to do that is really what counts. So thank you so much.
I'll try and make all of you the list of them.
Sarah was on our church committee, our church council, and served well there. And with her leaving, the council have co-opted two people to serve on council for the next annual church meeting, when they will be go through the normal process of voting. And one of them is not here today, is Gerard. Who was actually confirmed at the last confirmation, but actually comes from a long experience of Christian work and Christian leadership in other churches and has a lot to offer our church, and then works a lot with the young people and with Jenny, and he will be one. And Silas, could you come on down, please? We have been greatly blessed by people coming to do postgraduate work here in Barcelona from different parts of the world. Unfortunately, most of them just come for 1 year, or just even a few months. And later on, Selena will be doing reading from us. And you're just here for, when do you leave, Selena?
End of July.
The end of July. And so the people who have a lot to offer, but in fact are only here for a short time. One of the things I've tried to do is for people who come with experience to have them on council, even just for a couple of years. And we did that with Stephen, who was ordained last week as a deacon. And we invited Silas to do that too. Silas is in his first year of a PhD. He has gone through all the checks and is working with the welcome and the sound upstairs. So thank you for that, Silas. Has been part of the leadership of the young people in Abuja Cathedral in Nigeria. And so we wanted to commission Silas too. And thank God for you, Silas, for your role in the church. And remember you, your wife, and your family. We enjoyed talking to his wife on Christmas Day when we had a meal here together. And so let me pray for you. And again, if you wish to put forward your hands, and anything you would wish to say first.
Say I found out about St. George's before I went to Barcelona through a Google search, and yeah, right, they asked me where I'm from. I said from Abuja, Nigeria, and that's it. So I'm here to worship God and to fellowship with this awesome family. It will be my pleasure to do the best I can while I'm in Barcelona.
That's very fun. Silas, I pray for you. Thank God for your willingness, ask for protection upon your family, and pray in your studies as you go on through higher qualifications that the Lord might be with you there and in your service. And I commission you and commit you to it in the name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. can see now as we prepare to go over the rest of the service. And we can't keep heading upstairs with Denise and with Jenny, I think.
Is Jenny free?
Yeah, she is. So we'll do it after this coming song. We're going to sing In the Presence of Your People. The words are on the screen. Please.
We repent of all our sins.
for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May Almighty God, who sent his Son into the world to save sinners, give you his pardon and peace, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. The prayer of the Church for today, the fourth Sunday after Trinity. Gracious Father, by the obedience of Jesus, you brought salvation to our wayward world. Draw us into harmony with your will, that we may find all things restored in him, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We're going to have two readings now from the Scriptures. One is from the book of Amos, and one from the book of Colossians. And Selena is going to bring our reading from Amos, and then right forward by Abdul, by Matthew, who will bring our reading from Colossians.
Thank you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. Teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is written in the law, he replied. How do you read it? He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. You have answered correctly. Jesus replied, do this and you will live. But he wanted to justify himself. So he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbor? In reply, Jesus said, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road. When he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him pass by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was. And when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. Look after him, he said, and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have. Which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers? The expert in the law replied, the one who had mercy on him. And Jesus told him, go and do likewise. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise be to you, Christ.
So please sit down. Thank you for all of those who have prayed for my father after his fall, and he is in a home. My father was never very good at do-it-yourself tasks. And it's interesting, as a 96-year-old, he just seems to enjoy life. And I can remember when he would say to my mother, I'll measure this for you, Jean. And what he did, I can never remember him using an inch tape or a measuring tape. He would go over and he would go like this, aha, the distance is that. It was a sort of a vague representation of what the distance actually was. It was not accurate. And that's why Amos talks about a plumb line, because what does a plumb line do? You hold a plumb line up, and because of gravity, with something heavier than water, it goes right up, and you know exactly what is straight. Many of you have been praying for the rats in our place in France, and thank God they're gone. As part of that process, one of the blessings was we discovered that the plumber who had put in the bath had been leaking the whole time. And all the floor in the bathroom had to be taken up. And unfortunately, rats were not covered by insurance, but the floor in the bathroom was. So they had to build a tub. And suddenly, the guy came and looked at it. He said, no wonder that nothing is straight. The house is 200 years old. He says, nothing is straight. What I've got to do first is make it straight. And when I was there last week on my retreat, there it was, the straightest floor I've ever seen in this 200-year-old house, because it was important to get it right. And that is what Amos is talking about. I'm setting a plumb line among my people, Israel. I'm setting them standards by which you must operate. Christianity, as it goes from culture to culture, has many changes. And at the core of all, things that they remain constant. The values that we find in the scriptures, values that we find in Christ Jesus, that remain there absolutely. I can remember when I was a pharmacist, I think I've told this illustration before, I got a phone call once when I was doing a locum, and someone phoned up and said, I think you've given me the wrong tablets. And I said, what do you think I've given you? So she said, and I looked up a prescription and I'd given her what the prescription said. But I said, what do you normally give? When she had diabetes, she normally, and I'd given her something for the heart. So So I looked up the others, and there was one for the heart right next to it. And I thought, oh, I wonder if they should have had the other one. And so I phoned them up and said, can you just bring your tablets in and have a look at it? And I discovered that it had been the wrong way around. It was actually the doctor's mistake and not mine, unfortunately. But I gave them out with the best intentions in the world. I thought I was fulfilling all the requirements. But in actual fact, both would have died if that woman had not noticed it. You see, there are standards, there are plumb lines, which have to be held to. There are things which make things right and not right. And it's important in the Bible that these things are there. In the psalm that was read, that we read together, how long will you defend the unjust and show partiality to the wicked? In a world where political power seems to include telling lies and injustice and wickedness, the psalmist says, how long will you defend that? Rather, defend the weak, defend the fatherless, uphold the cause of the poor and the oppressed. Rescue the weak and needy. Deliver them from the hand of the wicked. And that brings us on to the Good Samaritan. Now, we all know the story of the Good Samaritan. Once I was, previous role, I was traveling with a colleague in Bolivia. We were driving along and we saw a body by the side of the road. And I said to my colleague, what should we do? Should we stop? He said, I'm not sure we should. He said, I know a Christian in the next village. And we'll go and see that Christian and see what they say. And I must confess, I felt the very opposite of the Good Samaritan. I felt very much like the lawyer and the priest in this story, just driving by his body. We got to the village and talked to the Christian leader of the church there. And he said, whatever you do, don't go near that body. He said, I will arrange for it to be dealt with. Because if you go, you'll be held responsible for its death. And you will be forced to pay for all the expenses. How you apply the story of the Good Samaritan is not always straightforward, is it? When we see so much need in the world, we cannot meet all the need that is there. But the core of it was the words of the lawyer, words that Christ uses elsewhere. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and mind, with all your strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. And what does it mean to live this way of life? That first thing, the reason I said me as well as I, is it's so easy just to think of it as me as an individual. The word in the Bible for you is nearly always plural. And we take it as individual because in English we don't have two in food. We take it as just us as individuals. The challenge to us as a church is how do we show the love of God together? I love what Silas said. Silas says this awesome family of God. I like that. I want us to be a place that is awesome in terms of how it loves and cares and shows the love of Christ. But it's not always easy, is it, to work out what does it mean to be like the Good Samaritan. The Samaritans in Jesus' story were not always good. There's other stories of the Samaritans that weren't so good. The Bible is not idealistic. It recognizes that in every society there is sin. In the Collect today, it talks about our wayward world, that everything we do is spoiled by sin. And yet, the message that Christ says is showing love. It's not just about nice words, is it? Showing love is how we treat people. Matthew is doing a PhD on veterinary science. And you know that in the Bible, you are taught to take care of your animals. And in the Bible, it says, give your donkey a rest every Sabbath. That the practicalities of the gospel are worked out in how we treat people, in how we treat animals, how we treat creation, how we treat the poor that we come across, even when we cannot help everybody. Jesus asks us to go and cross boundaries. What does that boundary mean for you? What are the boundaries that affect you? And the boundaries come in all different ways. I went to an education system in Scotland, which was called the grammar school system. You had to pass an exam at 11 o'clock, and you passed the exam, then you get into grammar school. And very few people get into grammar school, about 10%, and I was one of that 10%. I came from, I guess, a lower middle class background. There was a guy in my year who was very bright, and he'd come from a working class background in a very troubled housing estate in that town. And he said to me once, he said, you know, John, it is really tough being in this school from my background. Not because of how people treated him in school, but because his family background said, you are being a traitor to us. By doing this, you are leaving your own culture. Crossing boundaries works in all sorts of different ways. And we are called to love the Lord our God with our mind as well as our actions. And that means as Christians, we've got to be people who think about what does it mean to truly love? And what does it mean to truly care? And our reading from Colossians tells us something about that. It talks about the faith and love that springs from hope. It talks about the gospel bearing fruit. It talks about your love and spirit. It talks about being strengthened and giving joyful thanks. And it talks about living with wisdom and understanding, that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please Him in every way. And I think one of that is holding up the right one mind. And whatever we're doing, that we're doing it in a way that perhaps Christ would have done it. And whatever we are in our lives, living God's standards. But God's standards are not legalism. God's standards are always the standards of love. And there's a challenge for us as we work to serve Him this week. What were Christ's last words to Luke, which to this ruler in Luke? It was, go out and do likewise. The doing of our Christian faith is to be the sign of what is inside us. What is inside us is not genuine unless we are trying to work that out in our daily life. And may God help us by His Holy Spirit. Amen. We're going to stand and enjoy together the words of the Creed, which are on your altars of service. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins.
Christ Jesus, our Saviour. And so we lift our prayers and worship in praise and thanksgiving to you, our Father in heaven. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for the Church, our Bishop Robert and David, our own leaders here, Chaplains John and Deborah, and youth worker Jenny, Churchwarden Sherry, the Council, Sunday School, and Leader Denise. We pray Leader Daniel, Leader Cousins of Adele, Rachel on the Costa Brava, and Padre Carlos at Santa Bernardo, the services at Andorra. We pray for those called to ministry, especially Darlene, and with joy of the ordination of Steve as deacon. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for Christians suffering and severe frightening and persecution around the world. Please grant them patience and courage to continue their witness of Christian values with trust and hope in the Lord. We pray for all those who suffer around the world, the grieving at the loss of loved ones. God of compassion, whose own son experienced life as a refugee, we remember those fleeing from danger, especially throughout Ukraine and Africa, hungry and afraid, with nowhere to call home. Dear God, please grant them your comfort and compassion. God of hope, we thank you for those who are working to bring relief and comfort to those displaced, showing glimpses of grace in the darkness of despair. God, give them strength. God of justice, guide the nations and the leaders of the world towards peace. Stir hearts to be generous and compassionate. God, help us to play our part in bringing about the change we want to see. Lord, in your mercy. Dear Lord, we pray with thanks for fellowship here among us, both living far, here and far away, for loved ones and neighbours with whom we share our daily lives, joys and sorrows. Strengthen our faith and trust in you. May we ask for your special grace for those who struggle against adversity. Fill our hearts with hope, love and joy. Where there may be anger, bitterness, division, let there be repentance, forgiveness and reconciliation. A moment for remembrance personally, in silence or aloud. Gwendolyn, Alan, Nketcha, Elsa, Janet, Jorge, Joanna, and Lima in Estonia. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful Father, accept our prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We ask for these prayers, mindful of the men themselves. Remember, nephew Aaron, who was married yesterday, he was at the wedding. And for David and Denise, who are going to be married this Friday, and to them came. We remember them before God. Please stand. Let peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you are called to peace. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's share peace of the Lord with one another. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to the Lord's event.
Thank you.
intercessions. Thank you to James for hearing Michael's intercessions for him. It's also affected our welcome team this morning. It was supposed to be Jimmy and Juliana doing it, and that whole family has been there with COVID this past week. Jimmy is clear, but Juliana is at home. And thank you to Jimmy for hearing the job of two people this morning. And greetings to your family, who are all been hit by this. Every week, for the last few weeks, we've had to rearrange something in a morning service. And I suspect that's the way that life is going to go on for some time. And this is where we need to show love and compassion. And remember what I sent out last week, that if you are vulnerable, then please wear a mask. If you have COVID but do not have symptoms, then also please wear a mask and be careful about the issue, of course. The rule of our authorities here in Catalonia is if you have symptoms, you should stay at home. If you don't have symptoms, you should do like everything else. But then do, as part of our love for each other, you show wisdom in this. And as much as possible, do go outside and talk afterwards, because there is more air out there and it's safer to do so. What we're doing for communion just now is there will be three cups at the front, one in the middle and two on either side, and two breads. And we're not kneeling for communion, but you come up and receive it, and then if you wish to receive the cup, then you then just move to the person either on the outside, who will have the alcoholic wine, or in the middle, who has a non-alcoholic wine. The Lord is here. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We join with the people of God through the ages, and we say together, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Jesus suffered on the cross. He died to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead, and you send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And our Father, on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took the bread and thanked him. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
And so we come and we bring this wine. And our Father, in your presence, we add to it this water to remind us that as a spear went into the side of your Son on the cross, blood and water came out. And we ask that by your gracious Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. And that we who share these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood. Pour out your Spirit on us, that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory. For honor and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus our your Son,
and the Holy Spirit,
one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please sit and we join in the prayer of our Lord Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Lord, hear me. We are one because we all share. From your faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance of his life for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive, but only say the word, and touch it. All who receive communion in any church are welcome to do so here. This is Christ's table, and he is the one who welcomes you. With those who are assisting, please come forward. together with the prayer after communion. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be our living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work for your praise and glory. This being summertime, there are not many community notices. I learned that one of the other churches in Barcelona actually closes during August because they reckon it's not worth keeping going because so many people are out of the city. But it's lovely to be able to remember Christ, to share his communion, and to think, how do we live for Christ in the heat? How do we live for Christ when our times are freer, perhaps, not as many, not as busy as other times? I remember once in August walking down Montaner and thinking, this is incredible, it's fantastic, it's so quiet. And potatoes were out cleaning the pavement in front of their places. And this must have been something like what it was years and years ago here. And as we come into the summer, Christ is with us in the midst of all that. This morning we had three people be involved. Selena, you're with us till the end of this month, I think. Is that right? And then go back where? Which country are you from?
Kenya.
We're going back to Kenya. Machi is from Nigeria and will be returning for some time, but then coming back. And James, that's it, next week, is his last week with us. And I want to thank God for all the students that we have as part of our congregation in Richard and Rogers. Many of our families are already away. But because we don't have a morning service, we have the privilege of John and Eleanor with us today. And Alberto back after having had his operation 2 weeks back, I think. And during the summer, let's look for opportunities to really love, show love and care for each other in our conversations afterwards. I think that's all the notices that I've got. There's an opportunity to pray afterwards at the front here, if anyone is wanting prayer, or if you've got something to give thanks to God for, then please come forward. And I think it's Jenny and Jenny who will be praying for people at the front today. That's all the notices I've had. Does anyone have The Wednesday Bible study continues. Wednesday evening is the online home group, which also meets in presence in our home as well. And so some activities are continuing right through the summer. Do you want to say anything about what you were doing this morning, please?
I can do. Just very briefly, last week, you know, we were looking at reducing, thinking of caring for creation. This morning I've come down cleaner than I expected because we've been painting, sticking in with the children and we've been reusing, which will continue next week. And the following week after that will be recycling. So anybody who would like to come upstairs and help, come and see what we're doing, you're very welcome. The children, I think, had a good time today. Yes? So we'll be filling you in with more information about that. The Caring for Creation Group,
which is
another
one.
So, thank you.
Thank you very much. We're going to finish by standing and singing a hymn, a contemporary one. Soon and very soon, we're going to see the King. What we're going to do is stand and sing this together.
Thank you.
you very much for coming. We have this group of three pianists who take turns at playing an honor to Pam and to... Where are you, Evelyn? You're somewhere at the back, I think. To Evelyn and Carmen. I just want to thank them. Pam is going to be... Carmen is going to be heading to Germany, and this will be her last time playing, I think, until September. Is that right? Yes. So I'd like to thank that team, because we recognize that so many things go on that we don't actually see very much. We hear the music, we don't see the person who's crouching down behind that instrument. And so just to all three of you, we just want to say thank you very, very much for all you do for us. Let's recognize that. Soon and very soon, we're going to see the King. I was mentioning my father earlier, and the last conversation I had with him, he said, I'm ready to go and meet him, John. He said, with a big smile on his face. And soon and very soon, when we go to see the King, we'll be there in glory, with all the understanding of God, which is only we have through our glass darkly, just now. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace, the love and serve the Lord.
Amen.